Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching session 1, installation and first program of a long web series Java and Web. Now we will learn about executable files in Windows. We are not going in depth of format of executable files etc. But we will see how a normal person recognizes the executable file and how we run the executable files in Windows. We will not discuss precisely about executable files, but a file that can be executed by operating system on the CPU is called a executable file. Using C or C++ program, we can generate executable files, but using Java, we cannot. In general, we cannot. Let's create an executable file using C program and run it. You may wonder what is going on here. You came to learn Java and now you are learning C. Don't worry, I just want to create my own executable file using C and want to run it. This is the C program I made. Don't worry about it. It will just print, let's learn Java. This is what the executable file is going to print. My intention is to create an executable file, that's it. Not to teach you C program. So let's compile it. Compilation done and then run it. It runs. But what happens behind the scene? Let's see. Behind the scene, it creates an executable file. Where you see properties, it is an exe file. So executable files in Windows has extension exe. Now we can directly double click on here. And it runs. So let's run Java. We can copy it and paste it on the desktop and then double click again. It again runs. So this is the executable file. Now we can run this executable file using command also. Let's open a command prompt, cmd, and run this executable file. If you want to run an executable file, you must be in the same directory in which executable file is. And now executable file is on the desktop. Then first see, where is the desktop? Desktop is in the same directory. Go to the desktop. Clear the screen and just type the name of the executable file. It runs. So this is the executable file. Can be run by double clicking on it or can be run by just typing in the command prompt. So we have created executable file using C program. We ran it. We copy the executable at the different place and run it by double click and also run it using cmd. When we pass C program like gyan.c to a special program, this special program is called compiler. The compiler converts the C file into executable exe file. Windows has executable file with extension of exe. Now this exe file can be executed on CPU by Windows. In Windows, the file with extension of exe is called executable file. Remember it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.